Item number, SCP-120. Object class, safe. Special containment procedures. Due to its importance to the Foundation, SCP-120 is to be kept under video surveillance and armed guard at all times. Any personnel attempting to utilize the item without authorization are to be terminated immediately. All personnel wishing to use the item are required to submit a filled copy of the application form to facility operators. Due to the precise timing and coordination required for efficient use of this object in an emergency, all personnel entering SCP-120's building are placed under temporary command of the facility heads, Captain Security Detachment L4, and Dr. Research Team L4. All destination locations are to be kept under surveillance and armed guard. They are valuable to the Foundation, but are non-critical. But any compromised destination must be immediately reported to SCP-120 personnel. Distributed Task Force Sigma-6, Puddle Jumpers, was created with the objective of protecting and maintaining SCP-120's facility and location outposts. It consists of one command unit and one defense and maintenance unit based at the SCP-120 facility at command, 5 units based at the destination locations, plus 5 reserve units for these, and 5 units assigned to other SCP-120 related projects. Description: SCP-120 appears to be a small child's paddling pool, pastel pink in coloration, with an inner diameter of approximately 2.5 meters, an inner height of 0.3 meters. The pool appears to have been fabricated from common earth plastics, but has shown itself to be indestructible by any attempted means. The pool's structure and response to pressure are typical for such a pool. It will flex when pressure is applied, and is soft to the touch, but has amazing tensile strength, and cannot be permanently stretched or ripped. What is constrained within the pool seems to be a brightly glowing, colored, liquid-like substance, which seems to exist only partially in our dimension. It is unresponsive to manipulation by organic or inorganic means, but the substance ripples and shimmers systematically and regularly, suggesting it exists physically on another dimension. SCP-120's most interesting and useful property is used regularly by Foundation personnel. Human beings, when alive and carrying loads, including clothing, under 37.8 kilograms, are observed to fall through the pool and are deposited at one of 11 destinations. The item will only function in this way if certain conditions are met. The subject must be genetically human. The subject must be conscious. The subject must be carrying weights of under the specified amount. And only one subject must be present on the surface. Test subjects attempting to use SCP-120 while these conditions were not met reported their feet making contact with a smooth surface underneath the liquid, but no significant effects were observed. SCP-120's main use is as a potential means of evacuation for command during a major emergency. It is currently stored and maintained in a fortified outbuilding of this facility. SCP-120 was first brought to the attention of Foundation authorities on 31/08/1992. Local police authorities in California were investigating reports of missing children in their jurisdiction and discovered and reported the item on 31/08. Overwatch Command was automatically informed through the usual channels, and a small team of Foundation agents was dispatched to claim and transport the item to Site-19, where it remained for testing over the next 2 years. It was transferred to its present location at Command in 1994. Addendum: Document 127. Destructive test results for SCP-120, 24/12/1993, abridged version. Handsaw, 30 centimeters, no result. Industrial drill, steel bit, no result. Industrial drill, diamond bit, no result. Munition, 9x19mm parabellum, no result. Munition, 5.56x45mm NATO, no result. Munition, 7.62x39mm, no result. Munition, 120mm M830 heat, no result. Cutting torch, acetylene, no result. Cutting torch, hydrogen, no result. Cutting torch, propane, no result. CO2 laser, peak power, 100 kilowatts, no result. CO2 laser, Peak power, 500 kilowatts. No result. Document 12010. Detailed explanation of SCP-120's capabilities and destinations. 1202-1994, abridged version. SCP-120 possesses the capability of instant translocation of human beings, possibly through one or more alternate dimensions. Subjects using the item are invariably deposited at one of 11 locations. These locations cycle in a specific and unchanging pattern. The 11 destinations and their locations were determined through testing with Class D personnel carrying radio beacons. Location 1. Pacific Ocean. SCP-120's liquid displays a blue glow while connected to this destination. Subjects attempting travel to this destination are deposited an average of 2 meters above the surface of the Pacific, latitude and longitude undisclosed. A Foundation ship, SCPS Demeter, publicly the USS Nassau, a meteorological ship, is currently stationed at this location, and personnel arriving through use of SCP-120 materialize inside the ship's cargo hold. Sensitive Foundation material or personnel can be sent here in an emergency, and the ship has provisions for storage of low-threat SCP objects, should the need arise. Class D personnel used to dial SCP-120 can be confined and extracted by helicopter, or reused, or simply terminated, and their bodies retained in storage. The original Class D and radio transmitter used to determine this location were lost at sea, and might have to be recovered in the interest of secrecy, if they were to wash up on populated shores. This configuration of SCP-120 was arbitrarily designated as number 1, and has no observable significance above other configurations. Destinations 2 through 11 follow in sequential order after this configuration, and return to it after a full cycle. Travel by SCP-120 to this location is not advisable during storms, due to risk of injury. Location 2. Greenland. SCP-120 displays a bright white glow while dialed to this destination. Subjects traveling to this destination materialize 1.5 meters above the surface of Greenland, latitude and longitude undisclosed. A small facility was established here, under the public pretense of oil industry expansion. This facility has similar capabilities in use to the Demeter, and is additionally equipped with an airstrip and refueling facilities. Location 3. L3. Located at the Earth-Moon Lagrange Point 3, the SCP displays a deep black color. Objects and personnel sent through the SCP to any Lagrange point, locations 3, 5, 8, 10, and 11, are effectively lost, as retrieval is impossible at our current level of technology. They may prove a possible way to remove small but threatening SCP objects, but for now, are merely an inconvenience, as sacrifice of D personnel is required to move the SCP to its next configuration. Location 4. Himalayas. SCP-120 displays a white glow similar to when it is dialed to Location 2. Materialization occurs on a mountain in the Himalayan mountain range, latitude and longitude undisclosed. Only minor changes have been made to the destination, the digging of an 8-meter hole for disposal of D-class bodies, an overhead canopy for concealment, and supplies and testing for evacuation to this location, which should only take place in extreme circumstances. D-class personnel used for dialing are to be injected with a mixture of sedatives and neurotoxin before sending, to ensure a humane death, and decrease risk of damage to the structures at Location 4. Location 5, L5, identical to Location 3. Location 6, Sahara. SCP-120 will glow yellow. Personnel materialize at a small outpost, latitude and longitude undisclosed. The need for secrecy renders this facility unable to house any significant SCP object, but is ideal for evacuation of personnel and documents from command. Location 7. Gobi. SCP-120 displays a brown glow. This destination is located in a small outpost in the Gobi Desert, latitude and longitude undisclosed, but is otherwise identical to the Location 6 outpost. Location 8. L2. Identical to Location 3, although shows more potential for SCP disposal, being situated beyond the moon. Location 9. Mare Imbrium. The SCP displays a subdued gray glow when dialed into this destination, This destination is on a relatively flat section of the Sea of Rains, on the lunar surface. Through vast expenditure of money and D-class personnel, a small outpost has been established there and is considered one of the Foundation's safest locations. Location 10, L4, identical to Location 3. Location 11, L1, identical to Location 3. Lesson complete. If you missed the previous orientation, go watch SCP-119, Time Crow Wave, right now. Or for the complete course, watch this playlist.